An Army helicopter lands at West Florence High School today to help bolster science and math lessons for students. Project SOAR is an educational outreach program that focuses on science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. The helicopter initiates discussions about the mechanics of flight. The patriotic nonprofit known as Celebrate Freedom Foundation.
Yes, high schoolers in the PD are learning what it's like to sit inside an Army helicopter. The United States Army donated the chopper to Celebrate Freedom Foundation, which is a push to inspire students to stay in school. The U.S. Army sponsors several tours to South Carolina high schools, providing this hands-on educational program. West Florence High School students had that opportunity to get up close to an Army chopper yesterday while learning about the mechanics of flight.
We help provide the teachers with lesson plans to teach them science, technology, engineering, math. So many schools now don't do that, and we've lost a lot of industrial edge in the country because all of our technicians have gone away.
Today, the tour will make a stop
Some
at Dillon High School.
Schools are giving kids the chance to learn outside of the classroom and inside of an attack helicopter, but it's not just for fun. Their visit to West Florence High School is part of the U.S. Army's Celebrate Freedom Foundation mission. The goal is to improve student performance, especially for at-risk kids. WMBF News reporter Crystal Moyer shows us how.
I'm sitting inside an AH-1 Cobra attack helicopter, just like the ones the U.S. Army uses every day in the Middle East. Now this one's in Florence. Program organizers hope a few minutes inside this cockpit will help keep students in school and expose them to different career options in engineering and technology.
I learned a lot. My experience was incredible. It was incredible.
That's the reaction most West Florence High students had when they walked out to find an Army attack helicopter sitting in the parking lot.
This is a $10 million aircraft. The schools can't afford that.
The Army donated the chopper to the Celebrate Freedom Foundation as an educational and recruitment tool.
To bring technology to the schools to help connect the classroom with the real world jobs.
The foundation started Project SOAR, traveling to at-risk schools, educating students about the different career opportunities in technology and engineering, even offering up some lesson plans.
We help provide the teachers with lesson plans to teach them science, technology, engineering, and math. So many schools now don't do that, and we've lost a lot of industrial edge in the country because all of our technicians have gone away.
Project SOAR directors give students the opportunity to sit in the cockpit of the chopper and teach them about all of the components that help get the helicopter in flight.
We bring these kids out here and we show them, if you don't want to fly, you can be a mechanic, or you can work on the radios, or you can do a paint and body shop. But there's all kinds of opportunities that you can do in the military and get a free career.
And some students say this experience may even change their career paths.
I would actually work for this. It's really interesting. It would make me change my mind.
Now students can continue with this experience. SOAR program directors tell me they are offering scholarships for an aviational space summer program for high school students. Reporting in Florence, I'm Crystal Moyer, WMBF News.